Okay, so recently Google celebrated the first year of the Gemini era. And certainly over the last 12 months, they've released a lot of models. We've not only seen the sort of 1.0 version of the models, we've seen 1.5 with the million tokens. We've also seen the Gemma models and the Pali Gemma models, a whole bunch of different things that they've released. And that brings us to today, where the Gemini era is now moving into a new phase with the launch of the Gemini 2.0 Flash model. So I've been lucky enough to get my hands on this model before it's being released today. And in this video, I want to go through what's new. I want to go through some of the changes that they've made, how this is a huge step in the whole direction of multimodality, and just look at how you can also get started for doing some of these key things. Now, the model itself should be out by the time that you watch this video. There may be certain things that I'm going to show in the video that are going to take a little bit longer to come to the APIs. But what I wanted to do is basically just go through and just show you where things are going with this new addition to the Gemini family of models. All right, so the first thing is the quality of the text outputs. So you should be able to notice that this is substantially better in certain areas than the previous Flash models. Now, don't forget, this is still a Flash model. This is far from the largest model. It's far from the best model, etc. But you should certainly notice for things like code, this model has gotten a lot better. Also for things like reasoning and agentic kind of tasks, this model has also gotten a lot better with the outputs. Along with those, Google's also tried to integrate things like spatial reasoning into the model, so it has a greater awareness of things like that. But really where this model shines, it's not just in the actual improvements in the text outputs of it. It's the improvements in the multimodality. So let's jump into that. All right, so the first big change that you're going to see with the new Gemini 2.0 Flash model is that it's no longer limited to just generating text out of the model. So with the 1.0 and the 1.5 models, we had multimodality in the sense that we could put in images, we could put in audio, we could put in video, etc. But now with the 2.0 Flash, we're actually getting to the point where the model itself can generate multimodal outputs. Now, one of the big things that it's able to do with this is to be able to generate audio outputs. And currently, those audio outputs are in the form of voices. So you're able to use Gemini to generate high-quality, steerable voice outputs. And while they're constrained a bit in the voices that you can choose, this certainly allows you to basically have the model be able to generate out spoken stories, spoken words, spoken analysis on things that you put into the model or that you prompt the model to respond to. Now, with this audio out, it's not just limited to English. You will be able to basically have the model speak back to you in a number of different languages. Now, I think at the first launch, they're going to launch with a certain number of languages, but you could imagine that over time, just like we saw many languages being added to the Gemini models, you'll also be able to get audio output in a variety of different languages coming out. So let's have a look at that.
Let's talk about native audio. So Gemini 2.0 introduces multilingual native audio output, but maybe you're thinking, what exactly is native audio?
You're actually hearing it right now.
Everything you hear in this video was generated with prompts. Like, you know, this actual prompt on your screen, like right now.
It was all generated by prompting the new experimental Gemini 2.0 Flash model like you see in this AI Studio screen cap. Neat, right?
Totally. Native audio is really, really neat. It's different from traditional TTS or text-to-speech systems. Like, what's super cool with native audio is you can do more than just prompt an AI agent on what to say. You can tell it how to say it.
Okay, so the second thing that relates to multimodality in this is not only can Gemini generate audio out, but can also generate images out itself. So this is not using an external model to make the images. These are the images that are coming out directly from Gemini. Now, this comes in a number of different flavors that you'll probably see demos of over the next few days. The first is the ability to generate out text with inline images. You could imagine if you asked Gemini to give you a recipe for how to cook a particular dish, Not only can it give you step-by-step instructions in text, but it can now actually give you images of each step as it goes along here. So this is huge if you think about it. You've now got something that can generate multiple images in the output as it goes along for doing this. This is an extremely challenging thing to do, and it's something that we haven't really seen in any of the models, either open source or proprietary, where the image generation is actually coming out of the multimodal model itself, not being generated by an external model like Flux or DALL-E or ImageGen, etc. You could imagine that this is going to generate a whole bunch of new business use cases of things where suddenly now you can show text and images in the same thing. The other element that this can unlock is allowing you to conversationally edit images as you put an image and text in to generate an image out. So if you've got a picture of your bedroom and you want to see what the walls are going to look like if you painted them red, you will be able to do that kind of thing where Gemini will be able to take that and generate new images out, conditioned on the image that you put in and the text that you prompt it with, etc.
This is a real-time screen capture, and all the prompts you'll see in this video are things that early testers can now try. And this is the entire prompt we gave it: turn this car into a convertible. And it generated this image. Here they are side by side. Notice how it successfully modified the car, but also managed to keep the rest of the image consistent. This is difficult in many AI tools that use separate models, but here it's all being done by one model. And we continued the conversation, saying, imagine the car full of beach stuff, and change the color to something that feels like summer. Explain as you go. The model began outputting text. It explained its idea for a new color, then showed it to us. But the really neat thing is that the model kept going. It went right on generating another image with the car full of beach gear. Remember that this is all a single response of text and image tokens coming from the model. This ability to output across modalities, interleaving text and image together, is one of the most exciting aspects of Gemini 2.0.
All right, so the next big thing that the Gemini 2.0 Flash introduces is the whole idea of the multimodal live API. So this is a bidirectional streaming API. And we've seen some examples of this kind of idea with OpenAI having their voice mode where you could talk to the model and that kind of thing. And that's certainly something that you can do with this bidirectional streaming API. It allows you to have real-time voice interactions, natural conversations, etc. You can interrupt the voice, you can change what you've asked it to do. All these things can be done on the fly. The cool thing, though, is this is not just limited to audio. So you're able to also do this with video, where you can have a conversation with it. And as you're streaming video into it, you can ask it questions about what it saw. So if you think back, this is really what the whole Project Astra that was sort of debuted at Google I/O was about, was this idea of having streaming video going into a multimodal model and you being able to interact with that via conversation and video at the same time. So you can imagine that this unlocks a whole bunch of different opportunities for chatbots, for live translation, for gaming, for anything that you want to have your users be able to interact in a live process. Now, just as you're doing this in the live process, it can also do the multilingual stuff that you've got going there.
I am a large language model trained by Google.
So what is your name?
I do not have a name. I am a large language model, not a person.
Okay. Is it okay if I call you Gemini?
You can call me Gemini if you like. I don't have a preference.
Okay, so tell me about Gemini. What is Gemini?
Gemini is the name of the large language model that I am. I am trained by Google.
Okay, Gemini is also a name for other things. What are those things?
Yes, Gemini is also a zodiac sign and a constellation. It is also the name of a NASA space program.
Awesome. So you can speak different languages, correct?
Yes, that's correct. I can communicate in many different languages.
Okay, so tell me about Gemini in French for a second.
Okay, I can do that. In French, Gemini is Gémeaux. It refers to the zodiac sign and the constellation.
No. I want you to speak in French. talk to me in French and tell me about it.
Ah, I understand. Okay, let me try that. Gémeaux est un signe du zodiaque et aussi une constellation. Il est associé à la communication.
Okay, okay, what about doing it in Italian?
Sure, I can do that. Gemelli è un segno zodiacale e anche una costellazione. È associato alla comunicazione e all'intelletto.
Okay,
okay, I will stop. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Yeah, can you speak Thai?
Yes, I can try to speak Thai. Do you have something specific you would like me to say?
คุณพูดภาษาไทยได้ไหมครับ?
Yes, I understand you. You asked, can you speak Thai?
Okay, so
is there anything else I can help you with?
Okay, so I want you to have a conversation with me as a man in Thai. Okay? คุณเป็นยังไงบ้างครับ?
Okay, I will try. สวัสดีครับ ผมสบายดีแล้วคุณล่ะครับ?
ผมสบายดีเหมือนกัน คุณกำลังทำอะไรอยู่ครับ?
ผมกำลังพูดคุยกับคุณครับ แล้วคุณกำลังที่อะไรอยู่ครับ?
ผมกำลังทำวิดีโอเกี่ยวกับ Gemini ครับ คุณรู้จักไหม?
โอ้ ดีเลยครับ ผมก็สนใจเรื่อง Gemini เหมือนกันครับ
Okay, very good. Explain to people what we just talked about.
Okay. We just had a short conversation in Thai. I greeted you as a man, asking how you were doing. You responded that you were doing well and asked me what I was doing. I said I was talking to you. Then you said you were making a video about Gemini. I responded that I was also interested in Gemini.
Okay, that's fantastic. What else can you do? Tell me a story about a red dragon.
Okay, I can do that. Once upon a time, there was a red dragon named Ignis. He lived in a cave on top of the highest mountain. He was known for his fiery breath and...
Okay, for the sake of time, I'll stop it there, but you can certainly see that conversation went on for about 8 minutes, and it was able to coherently answer me in a variety of different languages, talk about different topics, a whole bunch of things. Now, you could imagine this is going to become really powerful when you inject the right starting prompt where you tell it that it's a customer service agent, where you tell it a little bit about a product or something, and then it will be able to answer questions in this. Now, one of the other things that makes this really special is that just as you're doing this bidirectional voice in, voice out going on here, we're still able to use things like tools. So we can add in the Google search grounding tool. We can add in custom tools, etc. So if you've got something that you want to use where you're going to have function calling going with this, this is something that you could use as well to improve the answers that the model is going to give back to you. So this really opens the door to you building a variety of different complex apps where you can have sort of real-time talking to RAG systems, getting data from many different sources, and being able to put it all together in there. All right, so lastly, one of the things that you're going to sort of see as well is that in the past, Google had an SDK for AI Studio and a separate one for Vertex AI. So one of the big things with Gemini 2.0 is the unifying of this SDK. So there's now a unified SDK which allows you to be able to do the development if you wanted to start out with AI Studio, and then use the same code and then just change the endpoint to the Vertex AI versions of Gemini, where you can perhaps get better quota and integrate it with other things that are in there as well. Okay, so Google has put up a blog about the Gemini 2.0 flash release. If you want to go through it, it shows you some of the things that I showed you and talked about in this video. You can find out more details about how to use it. If you want to use the model yourself, you can come along to AI Studio and try it out there. Or you should be able to try it out in Vertex AI as well. I will certainly be making some more videos over the next couple of weeks of showing, building some apps with this model and showing, you know, what it can do a little bit more. And especially as all the features come out of preview, we can look at some of the really cool things that you can actually start building with this. And I'd love to hear from people in the comments about, you know, what are you most interested to see working? What kind of apps would you like to build with it? Any questions that you have, that kind of thing. Anyway, as always, if you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.